In this problem, a block of mass m is acted on by applied constant forces F1, and F2, and the object moves a distance s across a rough horizontal surface. And we are asked to find the net work done by all the forces acting on the block. And we have to ignore our resistance. And you can see all the forces are given in the question, and also we know the angle between phi and angle between F1 and F2. So this is the strategy. We have to first start by drawing a free body diagram. So we know that when we draw a free body diagram, we have to first show the positive x direction and positive y direction. And after you specify that, let's draw the forces. I'm going to start by drawing the weight. It acts directly downwards. And then we have the force F2 to the right. And force F1. F1 is applied at an angle of phi above F2, and then you have the normal force directly upwards.
Pay attention to the relative magnitude of forces. If you add the
normal force and the y component of F1, it should balance out with the weight. Then we have the kinetic friction. Friction always opposes the motion. There's a relative motion between the object and the surface, so it is the kinetic friction. Okay, now let's see the second step in the strategy. We have to calculate the work done by each force. Let's look at the equation to calculate the work. So work is equal to force times displacement times cosine theta. So you need to understand this force is just the magnitude of the force. D is just the magnitude of the displacement. And theta is the angle between the force vector and the displacement vector. So you don't have to put the negative sign for the force or the displacement because they are scalars. So please make sure you guys do not put the sign. Angle will take care of the sign. So just put the magnitude of the force vector and then magnitude of the displacement vector. Okay, so that's how we calculate the work. And let's see, the next step is we have to draw a work diagram. So before we draw a work diagram, let's see the steps. We're going to draw the force vector and then draw the displacement vector so that their tails touch, and then label the angle between them. So for the first one, F1, the work diagram is already drawn for you, and then F1 is equal to 100 newtons, and then displacement 30 meters, and then 100 newtons times 30 meters times the angle cosine 30, you get 2598 joules. And let's do the second one. For the second one, I'm going to use force 2. I'm going to calculate the work done by force 2. And let's see the work diagram. So I'm going to first draw the force vector F2 and then the displacement vector, which is equal to 30 meters. And force vector is acting in the same direction as the displacement vector. So as a result, angle is just equal to 0, right? So I'm going to actually include the information here. D is equal to 30 meters, F2 200 newtons, and angle is 0 because the force vector and displacement vector both act in the same direction. And work is equal to force, the magnitude of the force, 200 newtons, times the magnitude of the displacement, 30 meters, times the angle, cosine 0. Cosine 0 is equal to 1. So if you multiply 200 newtons times 30 meters, you get 6,000 joules. And then let's calculate the work done by kinetic friction force. And again, in the work diagram, I'm going to show the displacement vector moving to the right. So the displacement vector is to the right, 30 meters. And then kinetic friction. Friction opposes the motion, it is to the left, and kinetic friction The angle between the kinetic friction force and the displacement is 180 degrees because they are opposite to each other, and work is equal to force times displacement times the cosine of the angle, and kinetic friction force is 50 newtons. Again, you just put the magnitude of the kinetic friction force times 30 meters times cosine 180. Cosine 180 is equal to negative 1. So you get negative 1500 joules. See, the sine is determined by the cosine of the angle. And let's calculate the work done by weight. Weight acts directly downwards. Displacement is to the right because the object is moving to the right. Angle between the force vector, the weight and the displacement is 90 degrees. So weight times 30 meters times cosine of 90 degrees, and cosine of 90 degrees is equal to 0. Just a reminder, guys, when you put these numbers into your calculator, like when you find the angle cosine of 90, make sure the angle is in degrees. If it is in radians, you will end up of getting a different answer. And let's calculate the work done by the normal force. Normal force is directly upwards. Object is moving to the right. Angle between the normal force and the displacement vector is again 90 degrees. And even before we do the calculation, we know the answer. We should end up of getting a zero for the work done by normal force because cosine of 90 degrees is zero. So that's just zero. So we have done the hard part. Now we just have to calculate the net work. We just have to add all the work with the sign. So 2598 joules plus 6000 joules minus 1500 joules plus zero, you will end up of getting 7098 joules for the net work.